Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another episode of Nugget's News. In this video, I want to go over my top 10 projects that are set to launch either to testnet, mainnet, or token swap in the coming weeks. Now, typically these blockchain platforms or protocols that allow for applications to be built on top of them have performed extremely well. So I'm very excited about these 10 projects. Without further ado, let's jump into it. So number 10, we've got Origin Trail. Now this one's got a market cap of 37 million. A fantastic use case of blockchain has been logistics, supply chain, proof of origin, and these guys have got a strong team. I'm really looking forward to this one going to testnet on June 30, and a lot of these projects are going to that mainnet or testnet around June 30. So keep an eye on this one, a good team, a good use case, and already building some strong partnerships as well. Next up, we've got Enigma. So also going to testnet around June 30, market cap of around $100 million here. We covered this one. It was one of my top 10 underrated projects for the year. Enigma Catalyst is the first iteration of what can be built on top of that Enigma protocol. So using all that data, privacy, smart contracts, we can start to build these crypto asset investing. So almost micro hedge funds of sorts. That's a fantastic application of the Catalyst technology that can be built on top of Enigma. So keep an eye on that one. Next up, we've got Republic Protocol. So for those that don't know, Republic Protocol is focusing on dark pools, so decentralized dark pools. So for people that don't know what dark pools are, it's basically trading books and, you know, that happens behind the scenes. So someone doesn't want to know, give away how many million shares they're selling, they'll use dark pools. So being able to do this in a trustless cross-chain atomic swap fashion, you know, all ERC-20 tokens, Bitcoin, Ethereum, this is going to be big going forward, guys. A lot of people aren't going to want to use OTC trades. Then they want to, you know, their privacy is very important. So this has already had a lot of big investing from some crypto funds. So this is one that I'm very excited about as well going forward and looking forward to using. I'll probably do a tutorial about that in some stage. Next up, we've got Credit. So market cap of around 45 million. Look, this one's been in the news a little bit. There was a few sort of concerns, possible red flags early on, but certainly now they're getting to that mainnet launch. This one is going to put the critics to rest if they do it successfully. So this one's a bit of a, you know, a platform, a good all-rounder, trying to build decentralized financial systems and database. And you'll notice with a lot of these projects we're going to cover, there's a fair bit of overlap because they are platforms on top of which they want all these different financial services, games, and applications to be built on top of. So similar vein of thought is Fusion here. Market cap around 130 million. This one is also trying to build that database, a bit of an all-rounder, but also interoperability is a big focus for these guys. So they've already had some big backers, but just look at all the different, you know, applications they're trying to build on top of that. But if they can get that interoperability between different blockchains talking to each other, that's going to be big going forward. So I'll just scroll down to the bottom here, the institutional supporters. And again, with all these different blockchains that are kind of competing and there's a bit of overlap, it's all about the partnerships that they can form, what businesses are going to use their blockchain, which really is critical and influential to their success. Next up, we've got EOS. So that market cap's around $9.5 billion. Their mainnet was meant to have been launched, but right now, as it says here, they're still transitioning to mainnet. So it's kind of, you know, been frozen by those block producers. There's no doubting that they've had a few bugs and they've had a few issues. The headlines have been pretty divisive and it tends to be a polarizing coin. People either love or hate it. So I'm really looking forward to the EOS finally getting that mainnet chugging along nicely. Once they do, you know, all those ICOs, projects launching on top of it, we can start to see the transactions per second that they're claiming. All those things can become reality and that's going to get a lot of people excited and have that real world use case. So keep an eye on EOS. Next up, we've got High Performance Blockchain. So market cap of around 76 million, and this is probably getting towards the serious end of this list because I believe this one is very underrated. So a lot of what they're doing has been focused overseas throughout Asia. So not a lot of English sort of marketing and, you know, collaborations and that sort of thing. And that can sometimes, you know, bode well. We don't want things that are being overly hyped, you know, on all the Western chat rooms. So this one is really exciting for me because it's combining hardware and software in the architecture, including this chip acceleration engine, as they're saying. So they're trying to get, you know, those claims of a million transactions per second, but using it at the chip level, at the hardware, all the way through to the software, to the blockchain itself. So really looking forward to seeing this one launch. Very strong team, very strong advisors. Again, one that I'm probably going to do full fundamental analysis on in the future. Next up, we've got Icon. So we're starting to get up in terms of market cap now, you know, 800 million. This is one that was very popular when I did my full fundamental analysis on hyperconnecting the world, as they say there. Now, this one actually launched their mainnet in January, but they still haven't completed the token swap. So people aren't issued their tokens on the mainnet. Now, that's happening in the coming days, or probably as we speak, if you're watching this video. I'll tell you how to, you know, keep an eye on for all these projects and how to make the switch to mainnet safely and successfully. But I really think that once they get the interoperability between blockchains again, there's a lot of competition in this space. But this is one, again, with a very strong team that's finally making that switch with their tokens over to mainnet, which is going to excite all those investors. Next up, we've got Ontology, and this one's performed extremely well. I know a lot of you, myself included, got airdropped those Ontology tokens. I'll talk about Binance and the exchanges that tend to be most friendly for airdrops and token swaps at the end of this presentation, but this one's just been on a charge in the bear market, continuing to grow, and performed extremely well. But what their focus is really is these different customizable blockchains. So trying to lay out the framework for people to start to use their business models and get them onto blockchains, onto databases, seamless transitions with all the different protocols that they're building. So again, a lot of applications can be done once they have this rolled out. Strong team, big backers, as we've seen in the media a fair bit. So again, all those crypto names you're going to recognize here, and especially Neo, that have been big supporters of this one. So finally, number one on the list is VeChain. Currently at about 1.7 billion market cap. Again, we've done full fundamental analysis on this one. A governance model, different tiers for the masternodes is getting a lot of people excited for VeChain Thor. Proof of authority, consensus mechanism that we covered. Check out that video if you haven't already, with full fundamental analysis. Again, these masternode type proof of stake blockchains can do more throughput. So, you know, we're talking thousands of transactions per second, possibly even higher. Different tiers of rewards are very attractive for token holders. If you can get that staking node up and running, or pool your funds with friends and get that going. So very attractive for a lot of people. These guys are disrupting a number of industries. Again, a lot of competition, but I think they're definitely leading the way. One of the oldest blockchain companies in the world. They've got bases in Hong Kong, Singapore, France. So very excited to see these guys making the switch very soon as well. So just finally, guys, keep an eye on the official websites. As you just saw me go through there, I'm only on their official websites, and then that'll direct you to their official, you know, Medium blog with step-by-step instructions on how to participate in these token swaps if there's anything you need to do. Keep an eye on their Reddit. That'll tell you what exchanges are supporting the token swap. So, you know, Huobi Pro here, supporting the Ontology token swap. But if you're not comfortable or familiar with this and you don't have huge amounts, then Binance has generally been the exchange that has supported that switch over to mainnet and done all that hard work for you in the background. If you're not comfortable controlling your own private key and using, you know, those contracts in the MyEther wallet, we've done tutorials on that, but it's still not easy to get your head around if you're new to this space. So that might be the best option for you guys, but make sure you go into the official instructions and not giving your private key out to strangers in Telegram groups or anyone that sends you emails randomly. Keep an eye on all those different videos, guys. We've now got them in playlists, fundamental analysis, top 10 videos, a few of those tutorials that I've mentioned. We're starting to really get this in a nice, easy format for you to go back and relearn all the content. We've now got over 250 videos. So I hope you've enjoyed that top 10 list, guys. Remember, the first three are going to testnet. Those next seven coins are going over to mainnet, apart from Icon, which is doing its token swap over to mainnet. So hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, share these videos around, and as always, thanks for tuning in, guys. Cheers.